Good day, everybody. Today, it's Mousetrap from Jataka Tales. I'm going to take you to ancient India. Come on, let's time travel to a period when India was the richest in the whole world. Only the best among the best is available in India. It's the best of the culture, the finest of the pearls, the exquisite of the jewelry, the shiniest of silk, the flavorful spices, everything is in India. You want to have a beautiful career, you come to India. The best of artists, the best of potters, the farmers were the richest, the people were very happy, and king the most benevolent, who used to think a lot about his own citizens. This story takes place in Varanasi, the city situated on the banks of the Ganges. A young man travels from a small village to the city in search of fortune. He wanted to make a fortune and he didn't know how. When he was passing by, he heard two men talking. One was the royal treasurer, a minister of royal treasurer. And the other, his friend. His friend was praising this royal treasurer. Oh, after you have taken the charge of this royal treasury, the treasury is just swelling up. The king is so happy. How is it possible? The treasurer said, nothing is waste in this beautiful land. You give a grain to my land, it gives gold in turn. Such is the might of my Bharat. So I put everything to use, all the assets of the king to use. We don't tax people out of their money, but instead we put our assets to use and generated income out of it. That is how it is. You mean to say you wasted nothing? Yes, nothing. And there was a dead mouse lying on the ground. The minister looked at it and said, a person who really has an entrepreneurial skill will make use even of that dead mouse. And this young man, his name is Kishore, from the town, from the village, was thinking about it. He picked up the dead mouse and he was walking. Oh, this minister is such a learned fellow. He must really tell. There must be some truth in what he tells. Let me take this rat. But what will I do with this rat? Thinking so, he was just walking. Then he saw a trader come to him and ask for this red dead mouse to feed his cat. So this young fellow, he traded the red dead mouse for 2 paises. And indeed, he started believing his Manasika Guru, his Guru, that minister. He said, okay, even a dead mouse can fetch me money. This is the first coin I have ever earned. I will spend it wise. Thinking so, he went and he was thinking what he could buy from the market. There was a market, one person was selling jaggery. So our little Kishore, he went to this fellow and asked, Anna, can you give me jaggery for 2 paises? So he got a little quantity of jaggery and he fetched a pot of clean water from Ganges and he took them near the forest. He knew many people who have gone to the forest will return with thirst. They must be finding it difficult to find water there. And as he thought so, a group of people were walking back. They were looking very tired. They were people who went to collect flowers from the forest. When they were arriving, Kishore handed them some sweet and some water. They were all overwhelmed for the timely help. And they said, how could we return your kindness? We all have only flowers. Each one of us will give a bunch of flower to you. Please take it. So R. Kishore took all the bunches of flowers, put it in the same pot which he carried for water, and went back to near the temple. There he sold all the flowers and earned some more money. So he thought, why not I make this as my business? And the next day he bought more jaggery and he got more water and went back and he continued the same. He did not stop giving water only to those people, but he went further down and went to a place where people were cutting grass. He asked, does anyone want water? Any of you thirsty? And all of them rushed to Kishore and gulped water. They asked, what do you want in return? Kishore said, not now, but when I want, I will certainly ask you. And this continued for some days. Kishore was a good man at heart. When he had lots of free time, he helped many people in the market. And he made lots of friends too. One such day, it rained a lot and with fierce wind. The king's garden was full of sticks and debris. The gardener did not know how to clean it all by himself and he was worrying. Kishore passed by that way and said, can I help you? And the gardener was really happy to hear that. Kishore went to the jaggery fellow. He got some jaggery and few children were playing on the road. He called them, hey kids, come here. And he gave them some jaggery to all. All of them were so delighted to have sweet jaggery. They said, Kishore asked, do you want some more? Yes, yes, yes. Then do as I tell. What, Mama? Please tell us. I will take you to a place. Please help me clean that place. It's a garden. Oh, Mama, we will all do it for you. Saying this, all of them gathered and within minutes they cleaned the whole garden and forming a human chain, they arranged all the sticks to one corner and it was piled up there, neatly stacked. And the gardener was so happy that he gave some extra money to Kishore. And Kishore said, can I use all these debris? Can I take it? The gardener said, of course you can. It is anyway a waste to me. As Kishore was thinking, oh cow, if a dead rat can fetch me 2 paise, certainly this one will also fetch me some money. And just then a potter was going by that way. And he said, hey, can you give me all those sticks? I would like to buy them. I need to bake my pots. And thus Kishore found a way to sell his dropped sticks too. Sticks and leaves too. That is exactly what the potter wanted because he couldn't find any during this rainy season. So Kishore made money there also. And then when the potter asked him to load all these sticks, he loaded everything and took them to the market along with him. There in the market, he heard people talking about a merchant who was carrying 500 horses and coming the next day. This made Kishore think, this is a useful information. If I plan it out right, I can earn some money through this too. So Kishore went to the grass cutters and said, oh my brothers, I would request you to sell all the grass to me for just today. And I would like all of it to be piled near my house by tonight. Will you be able to do that? And I will pay you the money. I don't want it for free. All the grass cutters obliged. They were happy to sell all their grass to Kishore as he would help them every day. They were insistent that they will give it free of cost, but Kishore would not accept. Because money should not come in between relationship. That is one policy he kept it strong. So when the next day, when the trader arrived with all 500 horses, he couldn't find grass anywhere for his horse. And the only place where he could find grass was Kishore. And he paid 1,000 coins for all the grass. And Kishore has become a very profitable businessman. Now, he wanted to expand his horizon. He has made many wealthy friends in the market. And through them, he got an information that huge ships of valuable goods are coming to the port of Varanasi for trade. So early the next morning, he got finest of clothes. He got a precious ruby studded gold ring as a loan from one of his friends, and a chariot and a charioteer. Then he set off to the port. He was the first man to go to the port, and there he received the trader, and he said, "I would like to purchase all of your goods, and I will return your money by the end of the day. Please keep this gold ring as my advance." So the trader was also happy to receive a big ruby studded gold ring as an advance, and to having sold all the goods to one person. So he accepted the deal and stayed in a tent. Kishore piled up all the goods in another tent and was waiting for other traders to come. He knew other traders would come and would want to purchase goods from him now. And that was the chance he was waiting for. When all the other traders had lined up, he managed to make a huge, very huge profit. And he felt that he has to thank his guru, the Manasika guru, the minister. So off he went to him, and with lots of money. And he said, "Oh guru, I am a villager who came to Varanasi seeking a fortune. I heard your golden words and implemented them. And today I am fortunate enough to have all these treasure." The minister was really fascinated, and he felt that this fellow has to be appointed with the king. And next day, Kishore was appointed as one of the ministers in the royal treasury. So, hard work with smartness and intelligence and entrepreneurship will definitely take us to places.